all the students. From the unit inverter, we got the new topic this year mentioned in the syllabus, which is three-phase full bridge inverter. So external examination also we'll get this particular question. We have already done with the single-phase bridge inverter, which is also called H-bridge inverter. So the circuit and the graph we have taken, which is quite simple, the single phase. But everywhere we require the three-phase bridge inverter. So because the load is three-phase load, example of three-phase load is the electric lift system and even the induction motor. So in many industries, we use the induction motor, how to control the speed of the induction motor and how to turn on the induction motor if the supply is DC. So we require the full bridge inverter. The three-phase load means here it is practically the induction motor. We have to turn on the induction motor with the help of the inverter. Now, let us have a look at this circuit first. So why the capacitor is placed? If at all the source is not providing a pure constant DC voltage, then we place a capacitor in parallel with this source. This is called, another name is voltage source inverter. In voltage source inverter, in parallel with the input source, we place the capacitor. Capacitor provides the constant voltage. That is, the input supply is applied across the terminals of the capacitor. Capacitor gets charged and a constant voltage is applied to the inverter circuit. So this is also called as six pulse inverter. The circuit is six pulse inverter. We are using six SCRs, 1, 2, 3. Okay, six SCRs. That's why the name is six pulse inverter. So now when SCR is on, energy is transferred from source to the motor. When SCR is off, the inductor, which is present in series with the load, releases the energy. That energy is fed back to the diodes, from the diode to the source and from source to the inductor. So from L plus inductor, de-energizing terminal, L plus to diode, diode to source, and from source to the load. So these diodes are placed in anti-parallel with the SCRs. These diodes are called energy recovery diodes. So you can see the connection. Six SCRs we are supposed to draw, and in with anti-parallel with each SCR, we are supposed to provide the respective diodes. This is the complete circuit for three-phase bridge inverter. We have taken in a simple manner why we are drawing the capacitor and the diodes. So now, what is the main use of this circuit? So when the SCR is on, motor rotates. Even when SCR is off, inductor connected in series with the motor releases the energy. That energy is fed back to the diodes, from the diodes to the source and from source to the load. So during this process also, when SCR is off also, for short period of time, we can run the motor in the same direction. Right. So first, after drawing the circuit, let us discuss what exactly the theory of this three-phase bridge inverter. Three-phase bridge inverter operates in two different conduction modes. One is 120 degrees. I can go for 120 degrees mode of operation or 180 degrees. So 120 degrees means what here? Each SCR conducts for only 120 degrees. We got six. In 180 degrees, each SCR conducts only for the 180 degrees. What is advantage? You can see here, we kept highlighted one particular point. 120 degrees connection is only used when star connected load is connected. And 180 degrees is used for star and delta. This is the major difference. And what is the advantage of 120 degrees mode? In 120 degrees mode, we can run the entire circuit only with two SCRs turning on. Okay, but in 180 degrees mode, at a time, the three SCRs will be turned on. Okay, so you can develop an inverter circuit with 120 degrees mode of operation or 180 degrees mode of operation depending upon the load requirement. Different character. This is the theory we are supposed to write. Right. So external examination, how we are going to explain this particular three-phase inverter circuit. First, the basic tabular column. In order to view the tabular column, this particular table. As I mentioned, it is also called as voltage source inverter. So here in the place of this MOSFETs, you can draw the SCRs, which I've shown you earlier. So input is DC. We are using 6 pulse inverter or 6 SCRs. And ABC is nothing but the load. So let us consider 120 degrees mode. Okay. Whether it is 120 degrees mode or 180 degrees mode, in each mode, 120 or 180 degrees, each SCR are fired for an angle 60 degrees. Okay, each SCR is given the firing pulses for an angle 60 degrees. If it is 120, SCR will be on for the 120 degrees only. If it is 180 degrees mode, each SCR will be on for 180 degrees. But if I'm turning on the SCR T1 at 0 degrees, the next SCR should be fired at the 60 degrees. Okay, so each SCR is fired for an angle 60 degrees. You can see this is the tabular column we are supposed to show. So what is the working operation we discuss here? Okay, get back to this particular waveforms. So first, let us check the how to draw this output voltage waveform. Bridge inverter will not generate pure sine wave. Bridge inverter generates the modified sine wave. Modified sine wave, this is the waveform. You concentrate on this one figure. Okay, this one. So how to draw, we'll explain. So this is the modified sine wave, which is approximately equal to the sine wave. Even this signal is given to the any bulb, any load, bulb or the motor. It is called six-step inverter. You see, the output can start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the next cycle starts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we must draw the output waveform in this manner. So how we are getting this output waveforms, we'll see the explanation. So three-phase output voltage, bridge inverter from DC to three-phase output voltages, three-phase output waveform, we can draw any three output voltages. 1, 2, and next one is the 3. Okay, the third one. So V1, V2, V3. In that manner, you can mention. But let us see how it works. So we've got the animation of this particular circuit only to understand how the circuit operates. So six pulse inverter or bridge inverter. Let us go for the 120 degrees mode. Okay. Examination, draw the circuit, go for the any mode, 120 degrees mode we are explaining. So in 120 degrees mode, only two SCRs will turn on at same instant of time. And other two SCRs are fired after 60 degrees. Okay, and two SCRs will conduct only for 120 degrees. This is the supply and this is the required output voltage. Now let us see first which SCR we are going to fire. So first we are taking the combination. Load means the same circuit, induction motor is connected here. So first you can observe, we are giving the firing pulses to T1 and T6. So this is the upper group and here it is the lower group. So one upper group SCR and lower group SCR should be fired. So DC supply is given, it flows through the mode 1, we can say, from V plus to SCR 1 and SCR 6 to the load. V plus to SCR 1, SCR 1 to the load, load to the SCR 6 and SCR 6 to the V minus. So this is the case 1. So during this process, you can check the output voltage waveform. Now one pulse is generated. Six pulse inverter, no. Six step. So modified sine wave will be, it will be mentioned in the terms of steps. Here step one is generated output signal. So we got three voltages now. Right. So now next series is 1, 2, 1, 6, 1, 2. Case two we can write. In case two, the 1 and 2 SCRs are turned on and supply the direction of the current flows from V plus to 1 to the load and from load to the 2 to the V minus. Now we are generating the second step. Now you see, but yes, two steps are generated here. But we require this sine wave. You can see here, But modified sine wave will, it will be generated in the form of steps here, which is approximately equal to the sine wave. Next case 3 is 3 and 2. So in this manner, we are supposed to explain 4 to 5 cases, how the direction of the current flows and this waveform, the output waveform you are supposed to draw. Let's take simply V1, V2 and V3, three output voltages which are displaced by angle 120 degrees. 3, 2 right now. Next 3, 4, you can see. So examination, different circuits you have to draw. If at all it is asked for the essay question. Case 1, what is the circuit? Only current is flowing from supply to the 1 and 1 to the, you have taken 6. Now here you can say case 4, supply to the 3, SCR3 load and load to the 4. So we are generating the respective output signal. You can see now 5 and 4. Next, 5 and 6. You can see now 3 and 2. The output voltages, these are modified sine wave. Modified sine wave is practically applied to the loads.